Now, before I talk about Final Fantasy II Anniversary Edition for the PSP, I must make a note that I've never played the original Final Fantasy II or any of the older ports of the game, so I have no idea how much different PSP version of this game is compared to the other Final Fantasy II ports or the actual original Final Fantasy II. So, that's out of the way, right? Now, after SquareSoft rescued themselves from the financial ruin by having massive success with their last-ditch title, Final Fantasy, they decided to release a second iteration of the game on the SNES. It's been more than 10 years since that time, and Square Enix, being considerate of those of us who never played the older Final Fantasy titles, has decided to port and remake some parts of the original Final Fantasy II onto the PSP. Quite frankly, this game is pretty much flawless. The hand-drawn 2D background and the animated character sprites are gorgeous and look fantastic. I personally thought the game looked really beautiful. The music is very enjoyable, and the turn-based combat mechanics are simple to use and really have nothing wrong with it. The surprising thing about this game is how you level up. You actually don't level up per se, but the more of certain skills or magic you do, the more that skill or magic will upgrade. For example, if you want to increase your character's physical strength, you just have to use physical attacks a lot. To increase your magic power or increase your MP, you just have to use magic a lot. The way magic is utilized is unique as well. You simply either obtain magic tomes from battles or buy them for really cheap prices, and then you go into your item inventory and use them on your characters. Once you use the tomes, your character is then able to perform those magic moves. All magic moves in the beginning cost 1 MP. And then the more you use your magic, the higher level the magic becomes. But at the same time, the more the MP cost equals the level of the magic. For example, if I use Cure a lot and raise it up to a level 9 Cure, then my Cure would cost 9 MP. And it's a pretty ingenious system, and it's pretty convenient. Well, at first anyway. Another unique thing about this game is interactivity with dialogue. It's not particularly deep, but when you talk to someone, there are certain keywords you can learn from them. Once you learn that key term to different people and get different responses, which may lead to learning more key terms. A lot of parts of the game require you to know the right keywords to say to specific people. It's very basic, so you don't have to worry about being hard, but it's still a unique system. Still, while the game is perfect and flawless in a technical sense, I cannot deny the fact that it's an extremely boring game. As I mentioned before, the way you strengthen your characters in this game is to have them constantly use their abilities and attacks. This gets extremely repetitive. It also doesn't make sense sometimes. To increase the defense of your characters, they must get hit a lot. At certain times in the game, I was having my character attack themselves so that I could raise their defense. After hours and hours of such upgrading, I got extremely sick of this leveling up system. Unique it may be, but boring it also is. I remember one time when all I did for 3 hours in the game was grind, and grind some more. The free roam overall design is a great concept for this game, but this ultimately led to extreme boredom. It's often hard to figure out where to go, and random encounters occur every 5 steps. You're never given any item to reduce, increase, or stop random encounters, so this was a big bummer. Lastly, the story was boring. The plot starts out with the generic evil empire is oppressing the country, so we must join the rebel forces to defeat them theme, and then slowly transforms into the nonsensical plot twist. Also, pretty much everyone you become close friends will die, either by dying from a wound or by sacrificing themselves for you. The plot twist is ridiculous. After you defeat the evil emperor, it turns out that your friend that you've been searching for from the beginning of the game has now declared himself as the emperor. So you go to him, and he's just turned power hungry. Just then, the evil emperor comes back from hell and threatens you. So you make a trip to a castle in hell and defeat the evil emperor again. That's the story. Yeah, it sucks. As for the dead characters, once you beat the game, you unlock a new game where you can play as those 4 dead characters and their quests in the afterlife. But it's not much of a replay value. It's boring as the actual game itself, if not more boring and more nonsensical. So, here's my problem with the game. The game is brilliant and has no real technical flaws. If I played this game back in, 1992 or something, I would have been just wowed. You can see that developers spent a lot of time and effort on this game. It's a masterpiece, but it's a boring one. The gameplay becomes tedious after a while, and the cookie-cutter story will not motivate you to grind for hours on end. As amazing as this game must have been for its time, it just isn't a fun game to play anymore. If there was ever a game that could be considered a boring masterpiece, I would have to nominate this game to be it.